In my last video, I talked about stretch goals and shared a really bad experience I had with them from my competitive swimming days. The responses I got in messages and comments were about 33%, yes, I love stretch goals. 33%, I hate stretch goals. And 33%, what the kind of pain management techniques did you use to swim yourself into a heart attack? So I wanted to clarify and provide a little bit more detail, since calling them pain management techniques is actually not 100% accurate. They are more accurately described as the mind control techniques I've used to achieve basically every goal I've ever achieved, from academia to sports to my professional life. I'm going to piggyback on Robin Kira's phrase, attention hacking, and refer to this approach as brain hacking. I've given a few talks at conferences about why it's so important to love being uncomfortable if you want to achieve big things. And that's basically what I will be sharing here, the how of embracing being uncomfortable. First, know your why. And don't just know it. Feel it, visualize it, and carry it with you. This is usually easy at the beginning of a journey and gets harder and harder as you start to encounter the inevitable hurdles. For me, it's better if the why has some kind of psychological or emotional pull, which I think is true for most people. If you're an agent and your goal this year is to grow your book of business by 20%, why is that your why? What will that growth allow you to do? If you're a carrier leader trying to achieve a 95% combined ratio, same question. What will that allow you and your organization to become? In both scenarios, how will you remind yourself of your why and keep it top of mind? For me, in the swim race example, my why was the points I would earn my team if I met my goal time, and the pride of closing out the season with a personal record. For me, the mental pain of not achieving those things was far greater than any physical pain I could experience during the race itself. So that was in my head the whole race, my why. And if the pain of failing your why is not excruciating, your why is not interesting enough. Go back and find a better one. Number two, envision success. There have been some really fascinating studies done around the power of visualization. Several have shown that the human brain doesn't differentiate between a real memory and an imagined one. This means that when you imagine something vividly and with emotion, your brain chemistry changes as if the experience was real. You can essentially trick your brain into learning new tasks more quickly and perceiving unknown challenges as known. Whatever success looks like at the end of your goal, visualizing it will help you achieve it. Number three, focus on what you can do in the present moment. The bigger the goal, the more important this is. What can you do in the next 5 seconds, the next 5 minutes, the next 5 days to get closer to your goal? If you're the agent trying to grow your book, what can you do right now? When there's no insured sitting in your office, no prospect in your inbox, what can you do in those 5 minutes to move closer to your goal? Sometimes this is broken out into minutiae. In that race, it was literally second by second. What I can do right now is raise my arm, turn my head to the left, and breathe. Then I can push water away from myself and propel myself forward 5 more yards. Whatever it takes. Number four, reframe negative feelings. This one is sort of a surprisingly effective fake it till you make it type deal. The physical symptoms of stress and nervousness are very similar to feelings of happy excitement. Reframing negative emotions as positive, even if you're lying to yourself, helps you perform better. But with practice, it becomes second nature because it's based in truth. You actually are excited to do the thing you need to do to move towards your goal. It's just that the fear is interrupting that feeling. So that's the cliff notes behind my secret sauce, the logistics behind embracing the uncomfortable. These four principles have been incredibly helpful in my insurance life. And I found that every time you go out on a limb to achieve a goal and don't die, you're a little tougher the next time you're out on that limb, reaching for an even higher goal. Would love to hear what works for you and how you push yourself towards your goals. Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe to the Insurance Nerdery, where it is cool to be a nerd. I'll see you next time.